I want to talk about some new legislation happening in Hawaii. I think that's really important because it sheds light on kind of the issues surrounding the chemicals found in our conventional sunscreen, if you will.
The impetus behind this is to save the coral reefs. There was a study done in 2015 by Craig Downs that reflected studies in 2007 and 2008, all showing that oxybenzone and octinoxate, both very common ingredients in chemical sunscreen, are damaging to coral reefs and marine life. And in fact, they tested the coral reefs in Hawaii and found 3,000 times the toxic limit. They say the reefs could literally die off in 10 to 15 years if we don't take measures now. I don't like the way that the opponents of this bill are talking right now. They're kind of saying, oh my goodness, everyone is going to stop wearing sunscreen and we're all going to get skin cancer. And it's like, you know what? If 70% have these bad ingredients that might be banned, there's still 30% out there that are like the ones that my family has tested that are based with zinc oxide.
And you have done hundreds of hours of research, interviewed many experts, and really kind of put your kids to the test with more than 100 sunscreens, right? Talk a little bit about what ingredient it is in this natural sunscreen and what you found.
There are only two mineral sunscreen actives, and that's zinc oxide and titanium dioxide. I tend toward zinc that has a little bit of a safer profile, and also it's the only sunscreen ingredient out of all of them, chemically included, that's UVA and UVB protective, so broad spectrum.
I'm not gonna lie, during commercial break, I hopped on Amazon Prime and already ordered, you know, the raw elements and the sticks.
One of our favorites.
All right, well, appreciate you coming in again. You can find Katie's top 10 pick on her website.